Sister Sledge.
Yes.
You need to keep the music down, the disco.
But I love the disco.
Mm-hmm. Remember what we have done for you here. We take you off the street.
Okay, I'll turn it down.
Are the actors? Well, not me, I'm the makeup artist.
We have come for your applause at lavatory facilities.
We've come to take you, Oskins.
That's right!
Don't you mean hostage?
Don't contradict me!
Little thing! Oh,
what do you want? What are you doing here?
Well, basically, acting work has sort of started to dry up recently.
No, the profanity!
1 week, I was painting the face of Mel, and then I was maced in the face by Jamie Bell.
Oh. I won a national television award once, you know. Then my last film got cunted.
Right, I know you well enough. I'll ditch this bushy tail.
Look, you don't mind if I just grab a drink, do you? I'm totally parched.
But why are you here? What are you doing here?
I wish to frequent the lavatorium.
Thanks for that. Look, don't mind if I make myself comfy, do you? I'll explain everything at our level. you're probably quite confused about what's going on, aren't you? We've been travelling around for a while anyway. You know, we're a dangerous gang. Yeah, we're a group of jobless actors. Oh, yeah, we've been travelling around looking for you, for this convent. We were all brought up here, you see.
Oh, really?
Yes, where we found our love of acting, and it's abandoned us, and all frankly, we're very upset with all of you, so, you know, well, see if you guys remember the last ones. It's me, you know, Alan. Alan, no, National Television Award winner, 1994. I did The Sickening, no, probably not. And then, well, I'll introduce the rest of them. And that, coming back from the toilet, that poor incontinent fool. That's Charles, Comb Baby, Champagne Chetner, Callow McKellen, Hassel Baron the 11th.
Greetings again, my co. Hostiles.
Poor chap. Used to be on stage as a Shakespearean thespian. Oh, many moons ago that was now, though. People don't have much call for combination of beauty and a booming voice. Brian Blessed and his beard have got that market cornered. Of course, Charlie, he's convinced that Brian stole his ideas. All he wants is one more appearance on Have I Got News For You to get his career back on track.
And the last pair of tights became ripped. No props, no poses, no plays, no script. Kicked out of acting school for playing the teacher's tart when I should have been the flirtatious fool.
We all eventually left the convent. First off was Keith. Keith Ledger, mime and ventriloquist. Oh dear, with his plucky sidekick, Spanky. Oh, he made his name eventually in regional theatre, ending up in Oldham's Regal Playhouse, moving into bit parts in the bill, Holby City. Oh, he had a great career ahead of him. And then disaster struck. Oh, he fell into drink, terrible drink. Eventually his brand of cheeky chappy mixed with terrible, disgusting words and behaviour just wasn't what ITV wanted anymore. On the set of the bill, he'd already met up with one of the finest makeup artists of her generation, and she came along as well. Mercedes Car Park. Oh, named from a multi-marriage of many stars from the days before. Back in the 80s, he was the biggest face painter in town. He was painting all the greats. David Essex, Pete Burns, which was hard work. And Big Mel, Mel Smith. By the time I met her, she was roaming the streets of Croydon, looking for faces to paint. She ended up working on corpses. And then there's me, Alan Montefiore. Don't you remember me?